All right, today, guys, I'm going to make a quick video here showing some of the differences between the X-Tool D7 and the D8. There's been a lot of questions lately about what are the differences between the two scan tools. Now, I asked X-Tool to send me a list of some of the differences, and they did send me a kind of a generic list. And then I went and found some differences myself, put together a list. And so between what they sent me and what I found, hopefully this video will give you a good idea of what the major differences are between the two diagnostic tools. Okay, so here we have the D7 and the D8. They both come in similar looking boxes, exact same size box, and that's on the outside. Now on the inside, you get your paperwork. The differences in the inside here that I noticed for the D7, this is the charging brick for the D7. The D8 has a much larger charging brick, which I'll show you that in a second. But as far as the OBD2 cable and the OBD2 connector for the vehicle, that's the same between the two scan tools. So let's pull up the D7 here. Get this box out of the way. As far as connectivity, there's a micro USB, that's for charging. Here's where you hook your OBD2 cable and a power button. That's it for connectivity. No camera on the back. No kickstand on the back either. So let me get this turned on. While that's turning on, we'll look at the D8. So the D8, get this open. The charging brick for this one is more of like a bigger power supply, kind of like what you'd get with a laptop. But again, and this one actually does come with a USB cable, type A to type A. Not sure what they intend to use that on, but it's an extra USB cable. Same OBD2 cable, same OBD2 connector. And let's get this tablet out and look at the physical differences. Okay, get this box out of the way. We'll get this one powered on. And I'll be back with you. Okay, so they're both powered on. I got a little post-it note here so you can tell the difference. Obviously, the D8's bigger. But we'll look at this one real quick. So there's a full-size Type A USB port on the top, the connection for your OBD2 cable, and the power plug for charging. And on the back, this one does have a camera, and it does have a kickstand. And the kickstand is pretty darn nice to have. You hook that on your steering wheel or set it on a desk or set it on a intake manifold or, you know, set it on the roof or the hood or whatever. Those are nice. I've got a list here. Some of the stuff up here is what X-Tool sent me, and some of the stuff is what I came up with. I will put this sheet up on the screen for you to read while I read it off. So they say the D8 comes with ECU coding capability on VW, Skoda, and Seat. The D7 does not. Well, other than VW, you know, some of those other brands we've never even heard of in the United States. The D8 comes with various special functions like reset, relearns under diagnosis, such as fuel injector balance, camshaft sensors relearns. The D7 does not. And that bullet point right there is going to be probably the biggest difference between the two as far as functionality is concerned, but we'll look at that later. Now, the D8 can work with FD protocol vehicles. D7 does not yet. Now, the D8 can work with add-ons like a digital inspection camera. D7 does not. The D8 has better hardware than the D7. See below. The D8 has a rear-facing camera. The D7 does not. Now the rear-facing camera probably isn't that big of a deal. Nobody's going to be taking selfies with a scan tool, but They do have functionality where you can use the camera to scan the barcode that every vehicle has now near the VIN number. So instead of having to manually type in a VIN number, you can use the camera to scan the barcode. But both these scan tools will auto connect to a vehicle or auto detect a vehicle VIN number. So that I've never even tried that function yet with the camera, but it supposedly does have that on the D8 at least. The D7 is 7 inches with a 1024x600 resolution. The D8 is 1024x768. So essentially the same resolution, but because the D8's one screen or 1 inch bigger, you got a few more pixels there. The D7 has a 4,000 milliamp hour battery. The D8 has a 10,000 milliamp hour battery. The D7 has 1 gig of RAM and 32 gigabytes of storage. The D8 has 2 gigs of RAM and 64 gigs of storage. The D7 has a quad-core 1.6 gigahertz processor, and the D8 has a 1.8 gigahertz processor. And there you can see the tablet size, about 8.5. The D7 is about 8.5 by 6 by just over an inch thick, and the D8 is 10 3/4 by almost 7 by inch and 3/8 thick, roughly. You see the measurements there. Both the D8 or the D7 and the D8 both have a 2-year warranty with 3 years of free software updates. And just as a disclaimer, this may not be a 100% complete list of differences. It's possible there are more differences that I have not discovered yet. So with that said, let's look at the functionality. Now we're sitting in my test vehicle I normally do these videos with. It's a 2006 GMC half-ton pickup truck. And ideally, I would have some sort of a OBD2 splitter, and I could plug both scan tools into the same vehicle at the same time. But I don't even know if that exists. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to plug the D7 in to this vehicle, and we're just going to kind of go over the bidirectional controls and the special functions. Not the service functions, the special functions. That's where they're going to be the main difference. Then I will unplug the D7, I'll plug the D8 in, we'll go back into those same menus and see what the difference is. Now, with that said, keep in mind, every vehicle you plug into is going to populate a different set of menus. We have one test vehicle, and we're going to see what the general differences are, and that will give you an idea of the functionality differences between the two scan tools. So let me get the D7 plugged in, and we'll look at those special functions. Okay, I got the D7 plugged in. I'm in my truck inside the garage tonight doing this video, and it's -0 outside, so I'm going to do this with the key on, engine off, but we should still be able to see all the same functions. So we'll go into diagnostics. We're going to go into... There, I just adjusted the camera settings, so hopefully you can see the screen better. We'll go into the D7 here. We'll click Auto VIN, Auto Scan. It's connecting. We'll go to System Diagnose. We're going to go into the powertrain control module because that one probably has, for testing reasons to show the biggest differences, the powertrain probably has the most functionality as far as like bidirectional control and special functions. So we'll go in there. We're going to go see this one here has actuation tests, which is basically your bidirectional control. This is where you would be able to turn things on and off, turn an engine fan on and off, or an AC clutch on and off, or a fuel pump on and off, something like that. So we'll go to engine, and so these are the things that I can turn on and off. Now, here again, glow plug. Well, this is a gas engine. There's no glow plugs. But for example, let's go to fuel pump. All fuel lines are connected. And we can turn the fuel pump on. I can hear it running in the back. You probably can't. And we can shut it off. So that is bidirectional control. And pretty much on the D7 here, whatever your vehicle has for any bidirectional control that it was manufactured with from the factory, the D7 is going to be able to turn that stuff on and off. If the factory manufactured the vehicle with that ability, this scan tool will do it. Now, I'm going to plug in the D8, and I think when we get to this point here where it says actuation tests, on the D8 there's going to be another one that says special functions. And that's where it's going to be like, you know, crankshaft relearn, stuff like that, where isn't technically yes, it is bidirectional control because you're sending a command from the scan tool to the vehicle, but it's not turning things on and off. It's more of a learn process. So that's where the difference is going to be. So let me get the D8 hooked up, and we'll go back to the same menu within the D8, and we'll see what the difference is. Okay, I've got the D8 plugged in. I just used the same exact cable and everything because it's the same between the two scan tools. We'll go into diagnosis. We'll click the auto VIN here. Auto scan. There is where you could scan the barcode with the camera and come up with that option right there. We'll get into this vehicle here and see what the difference is. Okay, so we're going to go back to the same like we did before. System diagnose. Again, we're going to go to powertrain. And here, as you can see, in fact, I unplugged the D7 at that screen so you can see the difference. Here's the D7 and the D8 at the same exact spot in that. And you can see there's one extra button right there next to my thumb, special functions that the D7 does not have. So on this particular vehicle, what are those special functions? Go to engine. Oh, it says oil life reset. But we also have fuel trim enable, fuel trim reset, fuel composition reset. So these are all the special functions. Fuel trim reset, fuel trim enable, crankshaft variation learn, fuel injector balance, fuel pressure control, cylinder balance. So you can see there's quite a few pilot injector balance procedure. There's quite a few things. So anyway, that's going to be the biggest difference between these two scan tools. The D7 is essentially a full bidirectional control on all modules, full live data on all modules. But if you want to get down into the special resets and relearns for the various components, this is the one here if you want all the goodies. Anyway, guys, that's it for now. Please be sure to like, share, and subscribe. Thanks for watching.